Qatar, a nation known for its rapid modernization and wealth, is also home to deep-rooted tribal heritage. In addition to the ruling Al Thani family, several prominent tribal families have significantly shaped the social and political landscape of Qatar. These families include the Al Khalifa, Al Sudan, Al Saud, Utubi, Bani Khalid, Kawasim, Ali Musalam, Al Ainain, Al Atiya, and Al Kuwari. Many of these tribes have histories that predate the Al Thani family's arrival, highlighting their long-standing influence in the region. The Al Khalifa and Al Saud families are kin to the rulers of Bahrain and Saudi Arabia, respectively. Families such as Al Sudan and Bani Khalid are among Doha's oldest residents, historically receiving exceptional rights and privileges, including exemption from pearl taxation. Without British intervention in 1868, it is possible that Qatar's peninsula might have subsumed under Bahrain or Saudi Arabia, or an established family might have organically risen as a ruler. In Doha, neighborhoods often reflect tribal affiliations and family councils, known as majlis. They play a crucial role in community decision making. Tribal allegiance extends into Qatar's political systems, where electoral systems exist. Most citizens vote according to their tribe, dividing the representative institutions along tribal lines and helping to diffuse dissent. We have several notable families as follows. The Al Khalifa. The Al Khalifa originated from the Utubi Arabs of Central Arabia. The Al Khalifa emigrated to Kuwait and expanded their activities into Bahrain and northern Qatar. By the 19th century, they were dominant in the northern Gulf region. Under the Al Khalifa, the northwestern city of Zubarah became Qatar's economic center until the rise of the Al Thani family shifted power to the south. Today, the Al Khalifa remain influential, with extensive intermarriages with the Al Thani family. Al Atiya family. This family has also strategically married into the Al Thani family, resulting to the prominent state appointments, including Qatar's first chief of police and most recent roles such as Deputy Prime Minister of Energy. The family has a historical association with the military. The Al Sudan family. The Al Sudan tribe immigrated with the Al Khalifa from Arabia, settling in northern Qatar. They are among the oldest tribes in Qatar and maintain a significant domestic presence in Doha. The Bani Khalid family. Once a powerful tribe asserting independence from the Ottoman Empire in the 19th century, the Bani Khalid established fishing villages and ruled parts of Hassa and Qatar. Al-Hassa and Qatar. Though they have lost much of their influence, their legacy remains significant. The Al-Musallam family. With the longest recorded history in Qatar, the Al-Musallam dominated northern Qatar settlements until being outnumbered by the Al Thanis and allied tribes in 1820s. An Ottoman source from 16th century designates a member of this family as Sheikh of Qatar. The Al-Kuwari family. Sharing common ancestor with the Al-Thanis, the Al-Kuwari family cooperates closely with the ruling family, resulting in influential government appointments. They originally protested an alliance with the Ottoman Empire by relocating the Fuariat on Qatar's northeast shore. The tribal families of Qatar, including the Al-Khalifa, Al-Sudan, Al-Saud, Tubi, Bani Khalid, Kawasim, Al-Musalam, Al-Anain, Al-Atiya, and Al-Kuwari have played a crucial role in shaping the country's history and contribute to influences in its political social landscape. Their deep-rooted heritage, strategic alliance have ensured their prominence and Qatar's evolution. Today, Qatar is one of the richest countries in the world. If you are watching this channel for the first time, guys, consider subscribing and liking this video. You can also hit the notification bell so that whenever we produce a video like this, YouTube will automatically notify you. Thank you, guys, and see you in our next video.